So all over mainstream media and your local news stations, you're seeing that major meat companies, pork and beef processing plants are closing. They say it's because of the coronavirus, which by now most of us have figured out to be a fake pandemic. So what's really driving these companies to close their doors and stop the production of meat? Well, it has a lot to do with Bill Gates, Richard Branson, companies like Tyson and Cargill investing in lab-grown meat and plant-based meat because they believe that animals emit too much emissions, CO2 emissions, and as a result, they believe that they should be exterminated so that they can grow lab-grown meat and sell it to us and infest our bodies with that crap.
What is meat? Back in the day, the distinction was pretty simple. Animals are meat and plants are not. But now it's getting a lot more complicated thanks to cultured or what some call fake meat. Just look at companies like Impossible Foods and Beyond Meat. They're developing plant-based proteins in labs and creating products that rival traditional grilling essentials like burgers and hot dogs. Now, the U.S. Cattlemen's Association is looking to draw a line in the sand and launch what could be the first salvo in a long battle against plant-based foods. Here's a look into the fight against fake meat. In February 2018, the USCA filed a 15-page petition asking the government to redefine the terms beef and, more broadly, meat.
Well, at this time, alternative protein sources are not a direct threat to the beef industry. We do see improper labeling of these products as misleading. Our goal is to head off the problem before it becomes a larger issue.
The cattle ranching group thinks if a product is going to be labeled beef, it should come from the flesh of real live cattle, not something that was grown in a lab or relies on plant-based ingredients, like veggie burgers and tofurkey, or anything that some critics have dubbed as fake meat. But the Good Food Institute doesn't like to use the term fake meat. The advocacy group actually breaks it down into two categories, clean meat and plant-based meat. Clean meat refers to meat grown from a small amount of animal cells in a lab. It's not on the market yet, but it's in development. Plant-based meat is anything that mimics traditional meat, but it's made mainly using plant ingredients, or is plant-based. Just look at the company Beyond Meat. It manufactures plant-based products in a factory just like traditional meat, only without using animals. Its Beyond Burger is so meat-like, it even made its way into the meat aisle in grocery stores.
From the consumers we see going to the meat case to buy our plant-based burger, which is where they're sold in the meat case, we see about 70% of those are at least vegetarian, people that have meat in their diet as well as non-meat proteins.
Beyond Meat's move into supermarkets comes at a time when U.S. consumers are cutting back on meat. Data from Health Focus International shows that 60% of U.S. consumers claim to be reducing their consumption of meat-based products. And of those cutting back, 55% say the change is permanent. So for companies cashing in on the growing plant-based market, a naming war could make for a rocky relationship with the beef industry.
We think that the cattlemen could face their competition head on, or like Tyson and Cargill, they could invest in this future. But rather than do that, they're petitioning the USDA to police the use of certain terms on labels and skew the playing field in the cattlemen's favor.
And it's not just innovation clean meat advocates are concerned about. The USCA's move has raised questions about the First Amendment, too.
I think their proposal would violate the First Amendment if the USDA adopted it. The government only has the authority to regulate free speech, like telling plant-based and clean meat companies how to label their products, if it's necessary to ensure that consumers aren't misled.
This isn't the first fight over food labeling. Just look at what's happened with the dairy industry. Legal battles over product names like butter and margarine, or milk and soy milk, have kept industry agencies torn for years. It all boils down to dairy farmers wanting to make terms like milk and yogurt exclusive. And after more than 20 years, there's still no consensus on the dairy controversy. We're seeing the same conflict now with the cattlemen. And with plant-based products on the rise, it won't be the last label to stir up some controversy. So while some see plant-based foods as a fad, others see them as a revolutionary force in the food industry. And sooner or later, U.S. agencies are going to have to make a call. But until then, there should be plenty of debate over the way you grocery shop.
People expect shortages or price increases for certain meats in the weeks ahead.
Several beef factories have been forced to shut down.
Nearly two dozen plants are functioning under capacity.
There is going to be a shortage.
It's been a volatile and crushing few months for the meat industry. In March, the shelter-in-place orders and shutdowns caused a complete shift in purchasing behavior. Panicked consumers moved from spending more than half their food expenditure outside the home to mostly eating at home. On top of that, an entire market was cut off when restaurants and schools were shuttered. By April, the coronavirus started wreaking havoc on workers and processing plants. By May 1st, beef wholesale prices were up 67% and live cattle was down 24%. Pork wholesale prices increased by 100%.
There was a number of cattle that were coming through the system, and hogs too, that were scheduled to be marketed at whatever price. And then all of a sudden, there's just basically no demand for some of those cattle because the packing plants simply cannot process them. And of course, at the same time, the cattle prices were going down because the packers simply couldn't demand all the cattle that were out there. That's what's got producers so upset right now. They see their price going down at the same time the meat price is going up, and they think that means that something nefarious is going on. And it's absolutely not. It's because those marketing costs have gone up dramatically, and the supply and demand in the two markets are quite different right now.
On April 26th, Tyson Foods CEO John Tyson took out a full-page ad in multiple newspapers warning the nation of a meat supply shortage. He wrote, "The government bodies at the national, state, country, and city levels must unite in a comprehensive, thoughtful, and productive way to allow our team members to work in safety without fear, panic, or worry." Oh, I can see right through.